Hello from Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we will cover plasma, which is the primary means by which a drug moves throughout the body. Upon completion of this video, students will be able to describe whole blood and plasma, define plasma protein binding, and define the free drug hypothesis. Whole blood is the main carrier of a drug that is transported through the body. Fortunately, blood is also very easy to sample from organisms, so one can sample a patient's blood, measure the amount of drug present, and learn how much drug is in a patient. There are two main parts to whole blood. One part is the cellular fraction: red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets. The cellular fraction is about 45% of the volume of whole blood. The other part is the liquid fraction, which is called plasma. Plasma makes up roughly 55% of the volume of whole blood. The cellular fraction and plasma can be separated from each other through centrifugation. Plasma has a pH of approximately 7.4. This is considered physiological pH. Drug concentration is normally reported based on the drug concentration in the plasma, CP. Plasma, because it does not contain cells, is easier to analyze than whole blood. Plasma consists of a number of components, including water, electrolytes, and proteins. The main protein in plasma, although there are many, is albumin. Albumin is 4 to 5% of plasma on a mass-to-volume basis. Albumin and the other proteins in plasma can affect the behavior of a drug in an organism. Drugs are often designed to bind proteins, such as a target protein. Drugs often also bind to plasma proteins. This is called plasma protein binding, or PPB. To the bottom left is the equilibrium for drug plasma protein binding. So you can have drug that is unbound and drug that is bound by a plasma protein. CP is the total drug concentration in the plasma and includes both bound and unbound drug. The ratio of the unbound drug to total concentration is called FU, unbound fraction. FU is determined experimentally by dialysis analysis of plasma containing the drug. Once FU is known, the unbound concentration of a drug can be calculated from a measured CP value. Unbound fraction is considered to be one of the key pharmacokinetic parameters of a drug. Let's see why it is so important. When we think about drug target binding, only the unbound drug can bind to the intended target, because drug that is bound to a plasma protein cannot also bind to the target. The free drug hypothesis states that the unbound drug concentration, Cu, in the plasma is equal to the concentration of the drug at the site of the drug target. Now, there are some assumptions to the free drug hypothesis, but these assumptions generally hold true for small molecule drugs, especially oral drugs. Why is a free drug hypothesis important? According to the free drug hypothesis, if you are trying to understand the in vivo activity of a molecule, you will likely find that the activity correlates more with the unbound concentration rather than the plasma concentration, the total of bound and unbound drug. Therefore, knowing the unbound fraction can help understanding drug activity and even in the prediction of drug dosing.
We have now described both whole blood and plasma based on their composition. We have described the importance of plasma proteins for both plasma protein binding based on unbound fraction and the free drug hypothesis.
I hope you found this video to be helpful. If so, please leave a like or subscribe to the channel. Of course, questions or comments are always welcome. Take care.